How's it going today, folks? Today we're going to have a little bit more in-depth conversation on print runs. I know we've talked a little bit on the channel, a little bit of introduction on it, but I just want to make a whole video on it because it really has been kind of eye-opening to me on how rare some of the product is versus other product and then kind of comparisons. So first we're going to go into Magic. Alpha of MTG Magic the Gathering was 2.6 million. For the alpha set of Magic back in 1993. The beta was 7 million, but we're gonna ignore the beta and just go into the original print runs. Then let's go into Flesh and Blood. Flesh and Blood had about 6 million to 8 million, somewhere around there. And then MetaZoo had about 80,000. Yeah, that's right. 80,000, if I did my math right. There's not a lot of conversation about specifically what I know that there's 2,500 booster boxes. So that's 25,000 cards. You think about that and how many there is for Kickstarter boxes versus what some print runs of Magic the Gathering. I mean, there are cards in Magic that are just huge. Obviously, Black Lotus, I mean, just basic land. So, I mean, there's crazy, I mean, I could go on and on, but there's crazy cards in both of those, in both Magic, Alpha and Beta, that are way more populated, and there's way more cards out of there than there is for MetaZoo. So let's just go in, like, if I were to go, and I mean, there's obviously a very big difference between a game that is 20-something years old, I think it's actually more than that, it's almost 30 years old. Oh gosh. But in a game that is almost brand new. But I just want to kind of point out the room for growth that MetaZoo potentially has if it does everything right and if they're going along really well. But I just kind of want to think about that. And then I think that Flesh and Blood has actually a better ratio because they didn't drastically increase it. So okay, so say we go to the next set. I don't think we know what the second print run of the Flesh and Blood set is, but I know that for MetaZoo, it 10x'd. So they jacked up the printer capacity, and they said, all right, we're going a lot. So they did from 2,500 to 25,000, which is just a huge difference, but that makes it go to about, I believe, 8.7 million. So then that's in line more of like the beta print run, which is about 7.3 million. Now again, granted, back in the 90s, people weren't using cases to hold their cards, they were sliding them on tables, their condition was worse, and again, it's a 30-year-old game almost. But just the perspective of that is really kind of eye-opening to me about the transparency of a company saying, okay, we're making this many cards, and there's this many of this card out there, and there's this many of this. Like, I think one of the runs was for Flesh and Blood, there are half as many Hearts of, I think it's Fendella, which is the cold foil fable in Flesh and Blood Alpha, which is just a crazy amount right now, but that there's half of the amount of the fable, or not the fable, but Black Lotus, which is in Alpha of Magic. Sorry if I'm going all over, but there are half of what is available, so it's technically twice as rare. So kind of going back to that, it's all subjective because these are two newer games versus a much older, much more established game. So you think about that, and let's say Flesh and Blood and or MetaZoo stand the test of time and they're alive for 20 more years. I mean, 20 plus a 50-year-old game, because I'm guessing Magic will also be around. Those are some rare cards. Let's just go, because right now Flesh and Blood is pretty bare. I wouldn't say MetaZoo is in bear market, but Flesh and Blood definitely is. And I would say that Flesh and Blood has cards that are probably the lowest that they will be. And you can't say they're a bottom. I can't use the guaranteed word. And I'm not a financial advisor, so if you're listening to me, you probably got some other issues. But I just kind of want to just think about that. If either of these games stand the test of time, their numbers are very low. Comparative or comparable to Magic. And so if we think about it, how much more rare are these cards going to be in the long term? Again, granted, those cards, the percentage of those cards that were probably not used in cases, not used, or were played with, is probably fairly high. So, again, it's a little skewed. But just kind of thinking about that, the room for growth in these newer games that are sometimes a lower print run than Magic, because I feel like Magic is kind of the gold star for print runs and how they established print runs, at least back in the 90s. How they're very, I mean, over time they've been open and said, okay, this is how many of the dark, this is how many beta, this is how many, all these very well-known, well-established games and sets. Versus some of these new card games, like, I know Flesh and Blood, hasn't been the most ideal in their print runs. I know that their alpha set has recently been spoiled, I believe back in December, or maybe it was late November, but it was one of those. But just kind of going back and thinking about that, about how rare some of these cards actually are, and where the room for growth is, and where... It's very interesting to me, and it's very, you know, kind of mind-boggling on how rare some of these cards are compared to, like, Black Lotuses. I mean, like I said, there's only 1,100 or something known Black Lotuses. And so, I mean, it's not that many in the world. And then kind of going back to what we've been talking about recently in the MetaZoo videos of how many red inks, blue inks, old scratches are thought or known to be in circulation. And I believe it's 100 of each of them. I don't think we know that for blue ink at this moment exactly, but we do know that about the other two. And that's crazy. Like, I think that especially blue ink, the one that's in Unlimited, will always make Unlimited a very good product, a very attractive product, because it's a low cost box. It should be a low cost box because it was mass printed. I believe the print run is 60,000 or something crazy like that. It might be higher. But just kind of going back to that and thinking about how rare some of these cards are comparative to the goodness gracious Black Lotus. Like, the fact that it's 10 times more rare and it's 10 times harder to pull based on the print run, I'm talking about blue ink specifically on this one, is just mind-boggling to me. So, just kind of wanted to give a little conversation today about print runs and how I think personally there needs to be a good transparency, but also not too much transparency on print runs. If they're telling you exactly what's in this, exactly what's in that, how hard it is to pull, that's too much for some people. And it's really interesting on how how encompassing print runs are and how rare some cards are. And especially with some of these Kickstarter games on how small some of their print runs are for their Kickstarter boxes. And again, we were talking about Kickstarter MetaZoo. We weren't talking about first edition, but we established that. But anyways, we're just going to wrap this video up just saying be careful with what you invest in, but also be knowledgeable on these print runs, because I feel like print runs are very important to how you establish what you invest in, how many of there are out there, and how popular the game is going to be long term. So with that said, see you in the future.